Hey, it's Tin Lan from DIY, and today I'm going to show you how to upgrade to BetaFlight 4 from BetaFlight 3 for the FPV drone. And some of the troubles that I go through with during the whole process, that you probably see the same problem as well. Hopefully that it can help you with. But before we're going to upgrade to BetaFlight 4, we're going to grab BetaFlight configurator. If you don't have it already, let's go and download it into your computer. Depends on your system, whether it's Linux, Mac, or Windows, to get the one that you want. So I'm using Windows. I'm getting Windows configurator tools. So as soon as I open it up and try to connect to my flight controller, it will say fail to connect. And basically, there are two things, either hardware problems or the software problem. All right. I'm going to talk about hardware problem later on, but for now, let's say assume that the software problem, okay? So let's say that you don't have a driver in your system, so you're probably gonna need to download some drivers. So let's go into this website and you download the CP210 driver for your bootloader thing, okay? So once you download it, you install it, still you can connect to your flight controller. That's okay. Let's download the little tool that you can basically install USB driver for the bootloader. So let's download that little tool, utilities. And as soon as I open it up and I try to find my device, whether it's listed in that tool, I couldn't see it. So I went to device manager to check out where the device is. So basically I opened the port, see it's the communication port, COM1. I only see that. I don't see other ports. So I know as soon as I see that, I know for sure that the hardware is not present in my system. So now it's about the hardware, whether it's a USB cable, some USB cable designed for charging your device only. They don't carry any data signal in that USB cable. So make sure that you use the data cable, okay? You need to get the data cable, okay, USB. So as soon as I switch another cable, I was able to detect the hardware into my system. So as you can see, it pops up as a communication port 6, as you can see. And now I was able to basically connect to the flight system. And as you can see, I'm still on BetaFlight 3.1.7. So I want to upgrade into BetaFlight 4, right? So I went to upgrade, I hit flash, and it wouldn't let me do it. So I tried to flash it, it wouldn't flash. So what's wrong with this one? I gotta figure out why it didn't do it. Let's go back to device manager on your Windows system. So it pops up as SMT32 bootloader with a yellow triangle. So it means that no driver loaded for that device. So as soon as I see that, that's fine. It leads me back to the ZDX where I can basically install the driver for that device. I reopen the software and list all devices. So I select SDM32 bootloader. As you can see, it's from the left side, a driver has none. And you want to select a WinUSB driver on the right side. And as soon as you select that, hit install driver and let it install the driver for that bootloader, okay? If you don't have a driver, there's no way that you're going to upgrade to BetaFlight 4. So that's pretty much simple. So let's that install. It takes like 2 minutes. And now I refresh my device. It will pops up into my BetaFlight configurator. So there you go. I unplug and replug it and it will show up into BetaFlight configurators. Now I hit update firmware, go to firmware flasher. Now it's loading it. That's fine. So it seems pretty good. For my target, I would select for my own devices, which is a LUX V2 flight controller. Yours may be different. You gotta figure out what flight controller you have and select the right target for your flight controller, okay? So there are so many flight controllers out there, so it depends on where you get them from. So you gotta figure out the correct target, okay? And then after you select your target, select the BetaFlight version, BetaFlight 4.0.6. The only thing that you gotta do is put flight controller in a DFU mode. Usually there's a button on the flight controller that you press it. You press that button on the flight controller and at the same time, plug in your USB cable. So as soon as you do that, the flight controller will turn itself into a DFU mode. Just hit flash firmware and there you go. Erasing first and then just flashing the new BetaFlight 4 onto the flight controller. So now it's successful, which is good. Now you can connect to your flight controller to confirm whether it's updated to BetaFlight 4.0.6. So as you can see, it connected and that's fine. That's basically it. You see, firmware BTFL 4.06. So now I connect the battery in there, so you can see 12 volts. So that's it. That's how I upgrade my BetaFlight to the latest one, 4.0.6. And hopefully you find it useful. And I'll see you in the next video where I update my BL Heli ESC firmware. The reason I'm doing this is because I want to show you to set the correct min check on the BetaFlight. I see a lot of people setting up incorrectly min check, how they set up the throttle with the BetaFlight using Taranis. It happens with BetaFlight 3. Still see it happening in BetaFlight 4. All right, that's it for this video, and hopefully you learned something about this. I'll see you next video, okay? Bye.